Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Claudio. So glad that you're here. If you are a first time visitor or returning, thanks so much for stopping by. Today I'm walking you through how to edit the new video templates that are now available in Adobe Express Beta. If you haven't tried them, you're gonna love them. So let's go ahead and dive right in. This is the homepage of Adobe Express Beta, new.express.adobe.com. And what I'm going to choose is video here at the top because I want to make a video. And I will scroll down here and I can see that there are these video templates. You see Instagram, Reel, TikTok video, Instagram story, YouTube videos, a regular video, and a mobile one. I'm gonna go ahead and choose this one here. First thing I'll do up here at the top, I'll call this Claudio's video. This is a good practice to get into the habit of naming projects so that you're not having to look for something that is not called Claudio's project. Otherwise, you'll have all these other untitled documents, documents with dates and so on. So highly recommend naming the project. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and close that there. And one thing that I want you to note here at the bottom, it says show layer timing. If you uncheck that, you're not going to be able to see the timing over here. So I highly recommend if this is not on to make sure that you select it. Now, when you're viewing a template here, I'm going to go ahead and scrub through here. You'll see that transitions between the text come in and out. And you also see her video there, very animated. And then I'll go ahead and keep scrolling through and I'll kind of fade out right here, or actually end. And so as you scroll through, you're seeing all the different content that animates in and out of this template. Now, each of those are going to be different layers. You're not going to see all the layers here within this layer section here. I'll start off first here by selecting the video. And so whenever you do select an item, in this case, video, you're going to see the adjustments for the video. Effects, color adjustment right here, and you'll see animations and so on. You can also mute the audio that's in the video. In this case, what I'm going to do, which is this button right here, this will allow me to replace that video. So I'm going to go ahead and upload one. But while we're here, there are tons of stock videos. This is like super exciting for me. I couldn't wait to see videos available. Now, these are stock videos that you can use in your project. So if you like, you need a video for something that you're putting together and don't have it, you could always use something like this within those stock videos. Right now, I'm going to choose upload and locate the video from my desktop. So let's go ahead and find that video and we'll bring that one in and it will basically replace the entire project. As you can see right there, it scrolled right through, replacing it. And I'm going to go ahead and scrub through and you'll see my video. It's a little bit laggy right here at the moment. And that's because I'm scrubbing through. But if I hit play, you'll see the full animation there. Now, this video I do need to fix because I have this up here at the top. And so what I'm going to do is, as you can see, if I move my cursor, I'm able to highlight that video. You can see it by the handles right here. So right now the video is not completely fitting in there. If I were to make it smaller, then it fits there, but I don't want some of that wall space for my video. So I'm going to just increase the size just a tad bit, probably go a little bit more, and just so that some of that is not there. And that's fine. All right. So now we're going to move on to the next piece here. And that is to adjust that text there. So right now it says meet Ariel Ezra. So what I'm going to do obviously is replace that with my name. And so when you hover over or you scrub through, what you'll need to do is whenever something appears and it kind of fades out, move the cursor or the line right here. That's what I'll just call it, the line. And then you're able to select the text. And then now the menu changes for a text option. And what I'll do is use Command A to select the entire text. And then I'll just paste in my name here. I'm going to go ahead and make some adjustments here. And if I move my cursor, I'm able to adjust it. So let's see how that looks like. Now I'll hit play and there goes my name. And then it fades out. FYI, I'm going to go ahead and move this over. I'm just going to show you here on the left-hand column. If I scroll down, there is a text effect. And then there's down here, shadow, shape, and then there's animation. So right now, currently, that Claudio Zavala Jr. text there, it's spinning in and then it drifts out. So I'll show you if I hit play, spinning in and then drifts out. So that is how you can add animation there. So I'm going to not worry too much about that. I'm going to leave it the way it is. And I'm going to move on to the next section here. And right here it says freshman orientation leader. I'm going to go ahead and select that entire text. And I'm going to go ahead and paste in there. Education evangelist. That's my title at Adobe. And right here it says at Midwestern State. I'll go ahead and click in here. This is an important thing here when you're working in Adobe Express Beta. You do want to make sure that you select that text. You'll know when you see it show up over here on the left-hand side. I'm going to go ahead and paste at Adobe there. So as I scroll through, there you can see at Adobe. And then if I scroll further, there's going to be some more content show up. I have a picture up here, and then I have some text down here at the bottom. We're going to go ahead and click in here. And then select it all, and then I'll paste my new text, and it is a little bit more text. I'm going to go ahead and just stretch this box out and just make it a tad bit smaller. Again, any animation that's attached to that is already there because of the template, so just a matter of just swapping out the text. Now, before I let that slide out, I'm going to address this picture up here at the top. Again, as I scroll through, you'll see it. We'll select the picture, and then over here you have the image options. It also has an animation attached to it. I'm going to leave that intact, but I will replace the photo. I'll upload a photo from my computer here. So let's go ahead and find that picture. And there is the picture. Now I can manipulate that picture further. Again, making sure that I have it selected. I'm going to choose the crop option because this was a vertical photo. I'm just going to adjust it a bit so that everybody in the photo fits there. And that should be good. So then when I scroll through, that fades out. And then I've got one last text box that shows up that says, so thankful for the space. I'm going to go ahead and change that to my text. Again, select the text, keep going until I can see the text, and then select all, replace it with that. I love that I do. That should be what I do. And we'll go ahead and make this, let's see here. We'll adjust that box right there, just make it larger, and then stretch that out and just make a little slight adjustment here. Just because I'll select it all and just make it a tad bit bigger. I'm going to go right here up to the text menu and just slightly increase that size till it gets to where I want it to be. Stretch it out. There we go. Just to make sure that it fits there. And then let's see how that looks. Fades out. Now, if I want to, I can do some further customizing of this template. I'm going to go ahead and if I want to, I'll click on the box back there. You see, that's important. As you see the highlight box, that will highlight the text. And if I move my cursor back there, see how that highlights. Now I'm addressing that box there. If I want to change the color, these are recommended. It's using AI to analyze my photo. If I want to, I'll do that. But I think maybe I'm just going to leave it the way it is. But just showing you that you can do that. And then one more thing I think I will do is I will adjust my photo, or I should say my video. I'm going to make sure that I click on my video. As you can see, the video menu shows up here. And there is some adjustments already on that. I'm going to go ahead and open that. And if I choose reset all, it will reset it to how it was when I imported it. I do like that just a tad bit. I will bring the saturation down just a bit. I'll just show you drastic desaturation there. Just going to bring it down a tad bit. Maybe make it just slightly cooler. Bring the shadows down a bit. Maybe the brightness contrast, bring that down. Brightness, bring that down. Let's see. I think we're good. I think I'm going to leave it the way it is. And there we go. I've got this. I'll go ahead and hit play. As you can see. And there we have it. Now, what I'll do next is, now that I've completed the remixing of that template, I can go ahead and download this project. And you can see here, it's file formatted as MP4. And then right now the video resolution is set to 1080. Now, if I go 4K, that's obviously going to be a larger file size. The video that I imported was shot in 4K. So if I leave it at 1080, that's fine. It'll actually be great resolution that I can share on some platform like Instagram. So I'll go ahead and download this, and then I can go ahead and share that. You just kind of wait a little bit for this to finish up. And that's how to edit the new video templates available in Adobe Express Beta. If you have any comments or questions about this video, feel free to drop it in the comment section below. Don't forget, hit that like button, subscribe, click the bell to be notified for future videos, and please do share this video with your friends. Thanks again for stopping by, and until next time, have fun creating. Peace.